What's up, guys? Your boy Hugo the Savage back in for another Monday Night Raw reaction. The first Monday Night Raw reaction of 2021. I love January in wrestling, man. Royal Rumble's coming. Damn near my favourite pay-per-view apart from Mania. A lot of times I find it more fun, to be honest. I have to be honest, you know what I mean? But we have Drew McIntyre versus Keith Lee. WWE Championship is on the line. We knew this match was coming. Keith beat Sheamus for this match, is that correct? To be the number one contender. And yeah, I'm expecting a great match. I have to admit that like Drew's been incredible. He's been a great champion. And Keith Lee, the stuff he can do as a big man is quite ridiculous. The stuff he can do in general, even if he wasn't a big man, but the fact that he is that big and he can do it, madness. Now I'm gonna just go with I don't expect Keith Lee to win this match. They could shock us, but I doubt it. I doubt it, man. You know what I mean? So, you don't go from being NXT double champion, getting called up, and then winning the title all within 6 months. I don't think that happens, but should be fun to see. I know that the legends are there. I think they're at the top of the ramp watching, so this should be interesting. But yeah, let's go.
McIntyre
slips. Keith Lee's so strong. Oh. Future shock. Could be over.
Saved himself this matchup, popped up the right shoulder to preserve his life thus far in this WWE.
I'm a fan of the legends. I don't think we needed a legend rule, and I am a fan of them. See Melina there, and that's nice. I thought Melina was going to sign for WWE again, but I feel like Tori Wilson was great. Rick, hey, shout out to Rick, man, costing Charlotte that match. That was funny, bro. I didn't do a reaction to it, I was too excited. I seen Rick and I clicked on it, you know, like that. As I was saying, I love the legends. You know me, I'm always here about giving people their flowers while they're alive, while they're here, while they're fresh. But it does feel a little bit desperate every time we have a special Raw or a Legends Raw. It's the same legends, which says to me that either people have a bad relationship with Vince, or these are the people they can just scrape together. And I don't think you should be scraping them together. I think they should have a legends thing every year, as like certified every year, and bring different legends. Now people who are watching wrestling now, the demographic is a certain age. What is he doing? Suplex. No. What? Did you see Mark Henry's reaction? What? He caught the claymore? Oh wow. Oh wow. Spirit bomb. Ah. Oh, keys balls up in your head. Claymore coming. This guy's a great champion, I have to say, man. But when Drew reverses you like that, and because he's that big, ball sack all up in your head, rude boy, you know, like that. Feel violated, bro. You might need me or him to come and give you a hug after that, bro. I like this. Sometimes I like the sportsmanship. I don't mind it with certain people if it fits their character. I think we know who's next for Goldberg. You're next. I must say, at this point, Goldberg's music's more exciting to me than Goldberg. I'm done, bro. And I think it's great, I think it's a legend. I'm not nothing bad to it, but now that Undertaker's gone, everyone can just stop now. Honestly, now that Undertaker's finished, all these other people who are not even on Undertaker's level can stop now.
There couldn't be a better representative to be the WWE champion.
And his last run in WWE, in his last couple of years, yes, have been terrible, bro.
You got athleticism, but the
one thing that you don't got
is a spear.
Is respect. Now I heard what you said.
That's not true.
But that's not what you were thinking. Because when you address these guys and girls, these legends up here, you look at them as a bunch of washed up, tired old men and women.
Well, all the women are only like 5-6 years older than Drew, so.
That now in your prime, you were better than every one of them in their prime.
Tatanka.
You think that not one of them poses a threat to you whatsoever.
That don't pose a threat to him, that like the finish.
Now,
that,
my friend, that's where you're wrong.
Man, my friend.
That's where I step in.
It's a good promo.
It's about respect.
Oh, God, man. Not Goldberg versus Drew, man.
So,
at the Royal Rumble,
don't think that I'm coming out here and I'm demanding anything by any stretch. Don't think that I'm coming and posing a threat.
Go fight. No, Big E wants to fight Goldberg. Go fight Big E, man. Stop the foolishness, bro. Who's this guy always just coming back demanding? He's lying about I don't demand. He always comes back demanding title shots.
I didn't expect any of that. That's not what I said. I think you're trying to get inside my head. Everyone over there, including you, knows Drew McIntyre is all about respect.
Yeah, super respectful.
Think about yourself 20 years ago, that big indestructible monster full of piss and vinegar taking everybody out. Think back, that's not you now. You couldn't be that guy. You couldn't beat me. Honestly, fighting you would be like fighting my own dad, mate.
You gonna hit it? Wow, headbutt him. Man, listen. Pardon my enthusiasm. I'm very excited for wrestling. I'm very excited for Raw. I'm very excited for 2021 and what it's going to bring. But I'm telling you, Goldberg fighting people now, it's always... Somebody comment below and let me know what Goldberg done excited in the last... Since he's been back. Since he started coming back, you know, when he brought his little kid in the ring and all that business. So, yeah, I get it. You want to lock superiority, kid. I get it. Yeah, you know I mean, there's nothing wrong with him coming back. But jeez, man, after that super showdown with Undertaker, I've been done with him, bro. Yeah, you know I mean, let me know that you can't cut it no more. And it's fine, bro. It's fine. You've got a great career behind you. You're a legend forever, cemented. It doesn't even matter if he does anything bad now, he's cemented, but... It gets a bit tiring, and I'm pretty sure that the kids today don't even want to see it, to be honest. It's always weird. Just think of this. Put it this way before anyone comes at me in the comment section. Goldberg's last match was at WrestleMania against Braun. Tell me what happened. I bet you don't even remember, do you? I bet you didn't even remember that to be fought. Because all he'd done was try to throw spears, and then Braun hit him with like 3 running power slams. It was dead food. And reminding you... That match was supposed to be against Roman Reigns when Roman Reigns was face, and it would have been spear versus spear, and they would have just speared the hell out of each other. It would have been terrible. Remind you that he beat The Fiend just by spearing him straight away, you know what I mean, before The Fiend took his jacket off and all that. Reminding you that he fought against Brock Lesnar and the match was over pretty damn quick because of just loads of spears. Reminding you that Super Showdown, it was terrible. Against The Undertaker, nearly killed him and dropped him on the neck. The Phenom was really nearly the dead man. Reminding you that he fought Dolph Ziggler. And even Dolph Ziggler, a smaller guy to the guys I've just said, he had to beat him just a couple of spears and it was done, ended, over. This is like the modern day Ultimate Warrior. It doesn't work. It doesn't work anymore. It's not believable. What Drew just said was right. It'd be like fighting my dad. It's not believable. Look at Drew. Look what Drew's done to Brock. Dismantled. In fact, look what Drew's done to the whole roster since he's been champion and on the way to the title. And what he's done to Randy. What he just done to Keith. And bear in mind, he didn't beat Keith up like that. But these guys are on. You know what I mean? Oh man, Goldberg, bro. That's one match I'm not excited for. Royal Rumble. But we'll see what Drew can do with him. See if Drew can probably carry him through the match or something like that. Because, yeah, it's not looking good. Back to what I was saying about the WWE Legends. I think there should be a show every year dedicated just to Legends. It doesn't have to be a pay-per-view or something, anything like that. Just be a, I don't know. You know what I mean? Bit of appreciation for each one. You know what I mean? Kind of like Hall of Fame, but they get, I don't know. Or maybe the people who don't make the Hall of Fame, because all them guys, Tatanka's not in the Hall of Fame. So, you know what I mean? There's certain people who won't be in the Hall of Fame. And my problem with it is, and it's not an issue as such, is that I'm 30 years old now. The guys on that stage, not all of them, because the Big Show and Mark Henry and all that, that's my era of wrestling. A lot of them, like Sergeant Slaughter and Hulk Hogan, Jimmy Hart, you know what I mean? These guys were legends when I was, like, not legends, but they were doing bits when I was, like, 5. Yeah? You know what I mean? 93, 94, 95, Royal Rumbles and all that. These were doing bits with, like, Tatanka was running around. When I was, like, 6, 7. You get me? And it looks silly because you got them backstage dressed up in their old gear, but why would you be backstage in your old gear? Like, Ric Flair's got it right, he's in his suit. You know what I mean? And don't get me wrong, Ric Flair's a legend as well, and he's probably is in his prime even before those guys, but he comes in a suit. He comes to, like, you know what I mean? But like I said, you can tell that it's the same people every time. Big Show always seems to be on hand. When they done the Undertaker's appreciation, you seen that kind of people there. These are people who are always around the company now. But I'm saying, what happened to the ruthless aggression legends? They are the ones that I want to see more of now, because I've seen loads of the 90s legends. And it's not me hating. I'm just saying that we've seen loads of them. Where are the I don't get it. Where's the ruthless aggression, guys? Do you know what I mean? You know what I'm talking about. There's all them people, bro. Like, every now and again, they remember the Hurricane, but where's Chavo, there's Carlito, and I know a lot of these people are still wrestling now, but you get them in, bro. You get them in, people want to see them, we want to be nostalgic about that as well, because as much as I saw these guys when I was really young, and I was interested, but I was 5 years old, bro, you know what I mean? I don't know what it is, I can't tell wrestling fans out to age, but it seems to me that when you really start taking, I don't know, when you get into the intricacies of matches and stuff, and storylines and all that, you're normally around 10, isn't it? Going onwards. So, but I ain't hating, because they're here, innit? And it's a beautiful thing that they're still here. And we lost so many legends in the last couple of years that I am happy to see the guys, but you guys get what I mean. Video's been long enough, and if you don't like it in the comment section, that's fine. And then people who keep coming into the comment section with the video starts, he starts doing a reaction at 1:06. Bro, you don't get to tell me how I do my reactions, bro. You know, like that. This is the channel for fans, by the fan, and I'm one of the fans, and I want to talk. If you guys want to speak, that's what I do the live streams for. If you want more live streams, we can do that. But the people who are doing that, I'm like, it's silly. If you want to skip to my reaction straight away, just do it. Or don't want to watch my reaction at all, but some people want to hear what I've got to say. The legends in my comment section. Yeah? There's veterans in the comment section. There are Demon Team originals in the comment section. So, just love it, but I mean, boy, who can save his comment, like, subscribe, and share. Don't be a bum. It's free. It was free in 2020, and it's free in 2021. Let me know if you want me to do a membership, which you're probably all going to say no, because you'd have to pay for it. I don't know what the lowest price is on a membership, but it'd probably be around the lowest price anyway. And I can do more stuff, you know what I mean? Because I got work to do in real life as well. You know, like that. Yeah?